Welcome to Proactive Investors. I'm Karen Tan in the Sydney studio. And now we're about to go to Hong Kong to talk to Yat Siu. He's the chairman of Animoca Brands. Hi, Yat, how are you?
Good. Pleasure to be here.
Lovely to see you again. Now, today we've got a big capital raising announcement for Animoca Brands by a subsidiary company to the tune of US $3 million, I believe. What are the details of this?
Well, so we basically just closed a capital raise as well as a sale, I guess you could, an issue of sand tokens for the Sandbox game. The amount is actually 3.6 million Australian dollars. Basically, we're very happy that we've got some leading blockchain partners and investors that are taking part in this round. Most notably, Hashed has led the round. And Hashed is, you know, one of the most influential blockchain investors, particularly in Korea. And I think it validates our strategy. You know, last year we set out and said we're going to sort of try to make an impact in the world of blockchain and gaming. And this is essentially our first big announcement in this area when it comes to actually sort of cash flow.
So tell us a bit about the Sandbox firstly, and then the blockchain version of the Sandbox.
Right, so the original Sandbox game was actually a, is still on, you can download on mobile, a 2D basically creator game, very similar to games like Minecraft or Roblox, but essentially on mobile and 2D. And in his lifetime as a mobile game, it grew to 40 million installs and still currently today has about 1.2 million active players. And when the team in Argentina were thinking about, you know, what's next for it, it saw this opportunity to basically create a blockchain version of the Sandbox, because unlike the other games, including Minecraft, you actually don't have true digital ownership, right, which is the big part here. But with a blockchain version of a game, you would actually own the items permanently. And so this is a whole thing about non-fungible tokens. So every item that's created in the Sandbox blockchain edition would become a non-fungible token, which means that you can, of course, use it inside the Sandbox game, but you can also export it, you can maybe sell it, you can possibly trade it. It's also user generated. So it allows anyone to make your own NFTs, which is new and I think a revolutionary concept in the world of gaming.
Who is the game targeting? Like, who's the market for this?
Well, as it is with the origins of the original Minecraft and also with Sandbox, the target originally is creators. So they tend to be older, you know, the demographic is in their 20s and 30s, people who love to make and create, you know, and the interface is a voxel style. So it's almost like building Legos. Now, of course, that means that much like Minecraft, it started off for older players, but there's obviously going to be a mix of players out there. And there certainly will be sort of younger players probably joining in as well. But the main original target has been sort of creators.
And what is the goal of the game, essentially? Is it, you know, what are the rewards?
Well, the point of the game is to create and to sell your items and to, you know, like every other game, you have social elements, you have elements of friendship, you have elements of sort of strategy. Because inside the Sandbox, you can also make your own kind of game, right? If you think about Minecraft, you know, Minecraft has over 90 million active players, which is actually more than Fortnite. It's one of the most successful games out there, but it is also a user-generated game, but it's not on the blockchain. Which means that as all these people are playing, creating their own game worlds, which is what Minecraft does, and also allowing people to sort of mint or create their own items, but these items have no value. And they also can't trade between servers. So any, you know, person who's played Minecraft or has children who's played Minecraft will know that they can only play and own these items in their own world. Once they leave that world, they don't own it anymore. But with Sandbox, you will own these items, much like in the physical world. So you can transport these items to other Sandbox games or even outside of it. And these items will have value. And so what we're hoping is we'll add this added layer with the Sandbox marketplace, where you can basically trade items, much like you could do on eBay, except these would be virtual items.
Now, with this multi-million dollar capital raising, where is it going to be applied specifically?
Right. So with the capital that's going to go in, it's mostly going to be for the developing, marketing, and distribution for the Sandbox blockchain game. And the other thing, of course, is that, you know, because there is a game utility token involved, that in itself will become a currency that can be utilized as well. And the investors have now given it a value because they've basically purchased these tokens as part of this sort of capital raise. And of course, the other thing is continuing to sort of, next step will be the rollout of the marketplace. And then after that, the full game.
And what time frame have you given it to get out there in the stores, on the shops, whatever, how would it ever distributed?
I mean, I think the marketplace itself is due in Q3. The voxel builder, which is the one, the system where you can start building your models, has already actually been launched as a beta and will go out fully probably in this quarter. And the game will follow thereafter, after the marketplace, so after Q3.
Sounds like an exciting project. Anything else on the boil for Animoca Brands you wanted to mention?
Well, I mean, I think the other thing worth mentioning on the Sandbox is that we also announced a partnership with Clayton, right? That's Clayton, actually. Clayton is the blockchain subsidiary of the Kakao company. So Kakao is the largest messaging company in Korea, worth like I think $9 billion plus, and they're, you know, they're also public, and they will basically be a strategic partner, and we will launch Sandbox on Clayton, i.e. Kakao. And that basically means that we will have a way of hopefully reasonably strong user acquisition possibilities for people to play and create on Sandbox.
Yat Siu, great for the update, and thanks for your time today. We look forward to seeing how it rolls out.
Thank you so much for your time.
That's Yat Siu from Animoca Brands.